Hi everyone, we are continuing with our topic, pneumonia. Today we are going to see part two. We have seen the definition, we have seen causes. Today we are going to see signs and symptoms as well as techniques to use to diagnose pneumonia. When you want to diagnose pneumonia, you start on history. If a patient has been previously well without any problem, suddenly there is an onset of fever associated with shortness of breath. Then you start suspecting pneumonia. And in addition to history, you will see physical signs and symptoms which include fever, tachycardia, the heart beat fast, tachypnea, a very fast respiration, productive cough, the patient might spit out, cough out, pus, possible hemoptysis, that is coughing out blood. The patient might be pale or cyanotic. The patient might be having localized dullness on percussion, and it will be also decreased sound when you do auscultation of the chest. The doctor might also hear the abnormal sounds, such as crackles or ronchi. Let's do this illustration, which would help us to understand cyanosis. Cyanosis is an important sign that will keep on coming, either for blood abnormalities or other respiratory problems. Let us try to understand what it is and how does it come. Once we understand it, it will help us to understand as well other conditions. Now, we are going to observe these two fingers are pink. Two of them are pink. They look the same. No problem. We are going now to use a shoelace, or a small thread if you may find one. When you take it, you tie the one of the finger. Now here we are doing it on middle finger. We are trying to block the blood circulation, the blood that is going to the distal part of the finger. The less we not that shoelace will not take too long. After 1 minute, we need to remove it, because we don't want it to take a very long way, the distal part will suffer. So as we are tying, we are returning all the blood backwards in the proximal direction. The distal part has no blood, no oxygen is going there. So it's a total blockage of circulation. Then we observe the index and the middle finger. Okay, we have it to observe. It will be just like a minute. Then we see what's the difference. We check just the tips of both fingers. If I see well now, I can see the nail of the middle finger is starting changing color compared to the nail of the index, which is free. It's not having anything tying it, you know. So this changing of the color becoming bluish to darkish now, as I see here it is pink, it is almost the same phenomenon that takes place in the lungs when there is a blockage, blocking the circulation or blocking the air. It will be blocking the oxygen to reach the destination. So the part that's supposed to be supplied with oxygen will start changing the color like this. If the problem is very serious, it can affect the whole body. It can affect the whole body. As you see, it's completely changed compared to the index. This is what we call cyanosis. This cyanosis, the patient who is changing the color will be in a cyanotic condition. Now, we spoke about dullness. We spoke about dullness where the lung that is full of fluid, on examination, you will perceive what we call dullness. Let's see and check and see what it is. Okay, so when you observe now in the alveoli, the lungs full of fluid, in the context of pneumonia, this is a pus. The pus in the alveoli, the segment that is affected will be dull when you do examination. Not only that, but also when you do chest x-ray, you will see what we call consolidation. The same area which is full of fluid will be looking like this, as the part which is normal will be having air inside and it will look dark on x-ray. You can also do blood test where we see what we call leukocytosis. These are soldiers of the body which will increase in number because they are coming to fight. The sputum might contain neutrophils and red blood cells. The neutrophils are the soldiers of the body that increase when they come to fight the infection that is going on. You can also do gram stain. The gram stain which helps to identify which type of bacteria is responsible for for this pneumonia. Okay, so pneumonia does not affect only adults. It does affect also little children, and it is very severe, more severe even for children. It does kill many children. As you see, the chest of this little child, it is really a severe one. It is it's bilateral. It had affected both lungs. Thank you for being with us in part two of this topic. We welcome you for the next topic, part three, and keep on coming and visit our website where you can find many topics. And always, when you have a comment, questions, you are welcome to send an email. Thank you so much.